What's up, guys? Welcome back to FTD Speaks. This is Miriam Gad. Okay, so check this out. Today, we have the scariest sins a Muslim can do. So, I'm scared before even watching that video, but let's take a look, see what they're talking about, and then I'll share my thoughts at the end.
Allah says, don't even go near fornication, adultery, zina. Don't even go near it. He doesn't say, la tazinu, don't do adultery, don't commit adultery. He says, don't go near it. In other words, there's the act itself, and then there is a series of smaller acts that lead to it. It's got a perimeter around it, and you can't even go close to it. One has to understand the language of the Quran and the sensitivity in which it deals with the subject to appreciate the wisdom of Allah Azza wa Jal and how He's counseling us in dealing with this problem. Allah Azza wa Jal is telling us there are certain things that in and of themselves are not haram. You're not going to be able to pinpoint it and say it is wrong. But when you get involved in it, you're going to get sucked into a gravitational field and it'll pull you in slowly and surely, little by little by little, and eventually it'll get you. Eventually it'll come at you.
Yeah.
You know, one of the things we learn about shaitan that is remarkable to me is that he's extremely patient. He won't get you one shot. He'll come at you and he will put a little bit and a little bit and a little bit and a little bit until he destroys your character. He won't come and make you do the wrong thing right away. You know? Even in the story of Adam alayhi salam and Hawa, inshallah one day we'll do that story and some of the wisdoms from that story in the Quran. The way he approached them in Surah Al-A'raf is really interesting. He was relentless. It wasn't just one time. Like we assume that he just came and said, hey, tree, doesn't it look good? And he was gone. No. He was extremely relentless. And he kept at it, and he kept at it, and he kept at it, and he built this idea in them until they would think it's their idea. You know? And when people start listening to shaitan, this is the same surah Allah Azza wa Jalla says, إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانِ. My slaves, you're not going to have any authority over them. In other words, people who really submit to Allah, He will not have authority over them. But others, الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرَ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ Surah Al-Baqarah. He will command you to do shamelessness. In other words, when you listen to him a little bit, you've granted him a little bit of power. When you listen to him a little more, you've granted him a little more power. And if you keep on listening to him, he gets to the point where he can command you. You will find yourself, I can't even help myself, Brother Norman. I can't even help myself. I don't even know. I don't know how to turn the computer off. I don't know what makes me do that every night. I don't know what makes me do this or that. I don't know what makes me go there. Go into that chat session, you know? Go and log into that, you know, horrific website. Go watch that filth. Why do I end up doing that? Why can't I lower my eyes when I'm in an elevator? When I'm walking down the street? I can't even help myself. I don't know what to do. That's when you know Shaitan's got a pretty good hold on you. He's got a pretty solid hold on you. And you've been sucked into a vicious cycle. It's just getting worse and worse and worse and worse and worse. And you're not addressing it and it's making the problem worse. And it's destroying your spirituality altogether. Your relationship with Allah depends on a heart being clean. Every time you're exposed to filth, more dirt, more blackness, more covers are poured on top of your heart. And it keeps on pouring and it keeps on pouring and it keeps on pouring to the point where you're listening to the word of Allah and you can't get yourself to even shed a single tear. It won't come because your heart has been made so hard because of all the exposure to filth, all the sin that your eyes are taking in all the time. And you don't even care anymore. You know, a good heart, when it sees something inappropriate that doesn't coincide with the commandments of Allah, it is disturbed. It's not attracted, it's disturbed. It says, no, that's wrong. Immediately the conscience kicks in, the alarm goes off. But when you're at the point, when you're by yourself, and you feel no guilt doing it, you just don't feel anything. You don't feel that it's wrong. The only thing you will, before you stare at a sister, you look around like, is anybody else watching? And then you take a good look. That means the fear of Allah is completely gone. The only fear you have is that of the seen. There's no more fear of the unseen. What a horrible spiritual state to be in. Allah says, يَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي
الصُّدُورِ.
He knows the stealing of the eyes, that little glance you caught. He knows that one, that little glance you took. What to speak of the stare. And He knows what the chests are hiding. You know why I brought up this particular ayah? Don't even go near zina. إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَةً. It has always been considered a lewd, shameless, vulgar act. وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. And a horrible path. Allah describes it as a path. a horrible path. In other words, a path has steps, right? A path is made up of steps. You have to identify which step you're in. What makes you get into this? You know, and for each of you, there's a process, there's a cycle. You're in a room by yourself. You know, you're at, after school, you've got a couple of hours before your parents get home. You know, you're among a bunch of friends that don't have any standards. You have to identify what leads you to this sin every time. And you have to cut it in its tracks. You have to stop going down that path. وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. What's amazing to me about this ayah, where it's situated. Right after this ayah, Allah says, don't murder people. وَلَا تَقْتُلُوا النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ. Don't kill any person that's innocent person essentially. Allah mentioned this crime first and murder second. Can you think of that? Like, we think of murder as this huge crime, right? But Allah says, when you violate the dignity of a human being, that's fahsha. Looking at a human being in that way is violating your own and their dignity. And when we kill a person, we have violated their physical, you know, their right to life. So there's the spiritual murder, fahsha, and there's the physical murder, qatl. There's two kinds of murder here. So Allah mentions the spiritual murder first. Our standards have gone so low. A movie comes out, you see a couple of trailers, you tell yourself, there's just one bad scene in it, it's okay. It's PG-13, it's not R. What used to be R 10 years ago is now PG-13. What used to be PG-13 is now PG. They put filthy scenes in everything now. And we don't even care about the spiritual price we're paying. It's affecting our prayer, it's affecting our dua, it's affecting our character, it's affecting our family life. It is. And we don't care. We just think, hey, that's life, bro, come on, live in the times. It's all right. That's just what it is now. What can you do? So many of you don't care what kinds of pictures you put up of yourselves on your Facebook pages. You know, I stopped going on Facebook for a reason. I don't say that Facebook is haram or whatever, but for me personally, I couldn't do it anymore. I just couldn't do it. You know, I stay in, you know, we'll put something up on our Bayina thing, like an announcement or this or that. But for socializing, just the things I saw were so disappointing. Like, how can you do that? You're Muslims. How can you post pictures like that? You know, have dignity for yourself. Have dignity for your family. Guard your gaze. You know, start with your eyes. The zina of the eyes, and everything else goes from there. Everything else goes from there. Inshallah ta'ala, I want to talk to you about this subject at length and do little small snippets and maybe portions from the Qur'an that deal with this subject. But the last thing I'll tell you today, inshallah ta'ala at least, is something about the word fahisha, which I'm translating as shamelessness or lewdness or vulgarity. The Arabic language has roots that are close to each other. Wahish and fahish. Wahish actually means wild animal. Fahish means someone who acts like a wild animal. Shamelessness is described as behavior close to animal behavior. Allah has dignified us as human beings.
The punishment that's of
Adam
cool.
on Adam alayhi salam was his clothes were removed. Our mothers and our fathers' clothes were removed. That was a punishment from Allah. And immediately they recognized that they need to cover themselves. They didn't learn to cover themselves from a society. It wasn't society that taught them to be shameless. You know, nowadays your anthropology professor told you, you know, it's society that makes us dress in clothes. You know, it's a sociological thing. We learn to dress and cover ourselves over history. But naturally we're just supposed to be the way we are, like all other animals. Adam alayhi salam didn't learn anything from any society. He was given a consciousness, and the moment his clothes were removed, he's trying to cover himself. Our mother's trying to cover herself. We are supposed to be a people that guard ourselves with covering, and we dignify others by not looking at them. Even if they don't have dignity for themselves, we should have dignity for them and not look. Because they are in the end a creation of Allah. Even if they're a disappointing creation of Allah, they are a creation of Allah. And we have more respect for ourselves and for humanity in general to not look at it as animals look at other animals. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us spiritually healthy and alleviate us from this growing and ever-increasing spiritual problem.
Okay guys, I did not expect that at all. One thing that just popped up when I was watching this video, specifically in the beginning when it was saying that this is a path, and when God talks about it, he's talking about the path itself, not just the act. So it was really focused on like the very first step by just looking. This is the path where you go to fornication. And anyway, that was similar to me when it came to drinking alcohol. I know there's a hadith, I think, that says, مَكَثِيرُهُ مُسْكِرْ فَقَلِيلُهُ حَرَمْ. which talks about if a lot of it gets you drunk, then just a sip is haram. This is my translation for it, but like this is what it means basically. And I can see how that is so similar to what Numan Ali Khan was talking about. When we have in Islam something that is haram, something that you shouldn't do, it always comes from the roots, right? Everything has an origin to it. So if we're talking about fornication, we're talking about looking, and then the looking goes to talking, and talking goes to touching, and then touching eventually can lead to, you know, before marriage. I really like how he was specific about explaining that part. And also, I really love the fact that he wasn't saying, oh, it's haram, you're going to hell, don't do this, don't do that, and that's it. No, he was actually talking about how the beauty of the Quran was tackling that topic, how it just touches on that topic in a very elegant and smooth way. This is the first thing. And then the second thing was that he was actually focusing on the dignity. He wasn't saying anything about like diseases or like having multiple partners or like how that can affect society in the long run or like any of those things that we are aware of. He was basically talking about the first step, the first thing that is going to be affected is your dignity and someone else's dignity, right? I sort of felt it more when he said it that way. Like, I know that fornication is haram and I know that there are so many reasons why that could be haram, but I never really looked at it from that perspective. And I really like the fact that he also mentioned how back then when Prophet Adam and Eve were created, and then when they sinned and they went to earth, they weren't covered anymore. And he said that their instinct, their natural instinct as human beings, without anyone telling them what to do, they thought of covering up. I have to agree with that. I have to agree that covering up is not really a Muslim or any kind of religious thing. I think it's just a human instinct. Kind of going off topic, today when I was scrolling through Instagram, I just saw one of the videos of women in like 1960s or something like that in the US. They're not even like, I'm not talking about Arabs or Muslims. And there was this dress that was shown to them. It was just not what they were used to back then, you know what I mean? And they were asking those women, would you ever wear that going outside? And they were like, no, 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 this is disrespectful. What kind of woman would go out like that? This is not how it should be. And it's not because they're Muslims. It's just because they know, which also plays a part from the society, of course. I'm not negating that fact, but I'm just saying that they knew that their instincts said being out there, not fully covered, or at least having your body exposed to people is not the human instinct. It just goes against everything. Obviously, nowadays, the world succeeded and Shaitan finally succeeded in just making us overlook that and just go with the flow. The society is just getting much, much worse these days. So all the things that were against the human instinct is now just the norm. And again, I'm not talking about religion specifically, I'm just talking about how the society works right now. But anyway, guys, I really enjoyed this video and I enjoyed listening to Numan Ali Khan explain specifically how that scariest sin works. I would love to know what you guys think, so comment down below and let me know. Do you agree with what Numan Ali Khan said? Do you agree that it's just a human instinct to just cover up, or do you think it's a society thing? Comment down below and let me know. Also, don't forget to check out other related videos in the video description section. Leave a like if you enjoyed this video, which I'm sure you did, and subscribe. I'll see you guys later, inshallah. See ya!